Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. Friends, if you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel yet, do subscribe it today and press the bell icon to receive notification about my new videos. In this video, we will see how to fix startup type grayed out for services in Windows 11, 10, 8.1 or 7 operating system. So what this actually means? In the default scenario, I will try to explain you what the problem is. So as we all know that background services are running in Windows 11 operating system. And you can access these services by running services.msc command. In the services snap-in, you can list all the services that are running in background for your Windows operating system. Here you will find that we have a startup type for the services. For some services it is manual, for others it may be set to automatic, and for some it is set to disabled. Now the problem is that this startup type is grayed out for some services, as you can see in this video for the Windows installer service. While if I go to any other service, you can see that startup type not grayed out, and I can change the startup type as I want. But for this Windows installer service in this example, you can see that the startup type is disabled and cannot be changed because it is grayed out. So how to change the startup type for such services, we will see in this video. When the startup type is grayed out, that means Windows do not want you to control that service. But luckily we have a way using registry to control or manage these services startup type. First, copy the service name which is mentioned in this property sheet. Now you can close the services snap-in. Then we will press Windows plus R and type regedit and click OK to open registry editor. Click yes in the user account control confirmation prompt. In the registry editor window, you have to go to H key local machine system current control set services. When you expand services registry key, you will find many registry sub keys, and each of these registry sub keys represent a service. So as you have copied the service name, you can locate its registry key. For example, in this case, we have copied the MSI server. When you locate the correct registry key for the service startup type you want to configure, come to its right pane and locate the start named registry dword. This start registry dword is the value that controls startup type for services. When you have it set to 4, that means the startup type is disabled. In case if you want to set it to manual startup type, you have to set its value data to 3. In case if you want its startup type to automatic or automatic delayed start, then you can set it to value data 2. Once you made changes to start registry dword, you can simply close the registry editor and simply restart your system to make changes effective. So in this case, we have changed the Windows installer service startup type to manual by setting value data 3, and now we are restarting the system, and after restart we will check if the startup type for Windows installer service is now set to manual. So after startup we will again access services snap-in by running services.msc command. Now the services snap-in is here. We will scroll down and locate the Windows installer service and double click on it. And here you can see that the startup type of service is now manual, which was earlier disabled. And if you notice, we have here the start button is also enabled. That means we can start the service as well. So this is how you can manage startup type of grayed out services in services snap-in. That's it for now in this video. Thanks for watching it. If you found it helpful, do like it, share it, and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos.